If you have rambunctious brows that kind of have feelers and want to lie down because they're old and tired. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to today's video, which is going to be my summer favorites of 2021. And it's not even that much because I was a very, very good girl this time. I truly tried to pick my favorites when it is hot outside, summer-wise. Yes. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. I'm 45, as I already said, which means that my face isn't as tight and as perky as it once used, like some other things that we're not going to mention. Yes. I am also light olive. And if you are those things as well, or maybe you just like makeup or like colorful makeup or just are very, very interested in how someone is going to be fabulous in their 40s and up, then make sure that you are subscribed because this is the channel for you. Yes, let's just get into the video because I'm rambling. It's intro number 5. It's one of those days today. It doesn't matter. I'm very, very excited though. Yes, my summer favorites. I feel like I've been a very, very good girl this year. And why am I saying that? Because I don't have that many products in front of me, for once. So, yay me. What did I do? I pulled my absolute favorites. Yes, which usually is very, very difficult for me. However, I have already filmed my summer eyeshadow palettes. So if you want to know the palettes that make me feel summery, yes, it is either listed underneath the cards or make sure you're subscribed because it's coming. I also just filmed my top 5 summer foundations. So I feel like I'm very, very good today. I am going to start though very randomly. Because there's something here that I'm going to start with that is I grab for in summer. Because in winter I usually don't use it and it's deodorant. I don't use deodorant often, and if I use deodorant, I don't want, I just don't use a lot of deodorant, and not that I stink, or at least I don't feel that I do. I just don't know why. I just don't like it. But I discovered this brand, and the scent that they have here in this brand, I'm like, ooh, it's very, very nice. It's a very subtle scent. It does make me not sweat, but it also, I don't know, it's just nice. And that is this brand. It's Natural Antica, I don't know, Nay. That's what I'm, N-A-E, Nay, Nay. I don't know, this is the one. The scent that I have here is Lemon Mandarin. It smells so nice. And they also have one that is Rosemary and something else. I love that in winter, if I use deodorant in winter, which is not often. But yeah, in summer, I use it more often. And this is just such a summery smell as well. It's just, it's so, I almost want to eat it, that's how good it smells. But it's just so nice to use. It does not make me feel, some deodorants make me feel, ugh. And they either, I don't know, they stained my clothing or they made me feel very, very weird and sticky, or just, I don't know, made me feel like there was a cement layer there. I don't know. I'm just very picky apparently with my deodorant. These I really, really like, and these are also vegan. So yeah, also everything that I have here is cruelty free. That is also very, very important to know. Okay, let's go to sunscreens. We all know we should wear sunscreens, and I use a sunscreen on my face every single day, even in winter. In summer, I want a sunscreen that is light in texture. And I have tried a bunch of different ones. I have tried Korean ones from YesStyle. And a lot of them peeled on me, but I did like the consistency. Then I found one that was before I went cruelty free on my channel. That was from Nivea, that I bought a bunch of. But it's too greasy for me in summer, but it is a very light texture. Now recently I found a new sunscreen that is truly new in store here in Europe. I have tried to find it in the USA or outside of Europe, and I'm so sorry, I cannot, but this is my favorite. So if you live here in Europe and you want a light thin texture, you want something that works beautifully on its own, beautifully under makeup, which does not make you look greasy, but it also does not give you a white cast. And what I also notice is when it says it's not giving you a white cast, sometimes it's that very powdery stuff. Oh yeah, and also I don't use a mineral sunscreen, because the mineral sunscreens that we have here are not nice at all. I posted this on my Instagram when I first got it. This is from Ombre Solaire, and it is the Super UV, the anti-pigment. Yes, Super UV SPF 50. You need to shake this up. This is so, so nice. This is La Roche-Posay, but better, because it's cruelty-free. Yeah, I actually like this one better, I think. You need to shake it up. And I'm going to show you how thin the consistency... Oh, it is spitting. How thin the consistency is. Yes, can you see that? It's so light and thin. It works beautifully under makeup. It doesn't make you look greasy. It's just, yeah, it's the bee's knees, people. Honestly, they had a sale here. Buy one, get one free. The day that I bought this, I tried it. The day after, I went back to the drugstore and I bought 6 more bottles. Does that say enough? I'm very sorry, my American friends, but this, if you are in Europe and you can get your hands on this one, try it. You will love it. But we don't only have the face, right? We also have the body. Now, for the body, a lot of sunscreens that we have here that are for your body are formulated to be water resistant. And that means that they have a certain type of feel that, for me, when I put that on, it feels like it feels like a layer on my skin. And I detest that with a passion. Now, however, I have found a body one that doesn't do it. And that's this one from Australian Gold. And this is the SPF 50. This is with instant bronzer. I did not know that. But this one, it's just so, so nice. It is very water resistant as well. But it doesn't give me that feeling that my skin is being closed off. I love it. It also has a golden sheen. We use it. The entire family uses this. I do want to give you a tip, though, if you are going to wash off a sunscreen, because I have found, especially with the sunscreens that we have here, they are difficult to remove. So what do you need? You need something like an oil cleanser for your body. They are out there. Yes, that is my tip. If you are having trouble with removing the sunscreen layer from your body, you use a body wash that has an oil substance in it. Okay, now we're kind of going to go to skincare. And if it is makeup. If it is extremely hot here, I don't do a lot of makeup. If it is very, very hot, this is not what I do. Basically, if I do foundation, it basically needs to be quick. But what I always do is brows. Because if I don't, I feel like I have a naked butt face. I've said it before, I look like Auntie Vester. Yes, we were having very much hot days here, and the brow products that I'm using currently, yeah, I know why they're a favorite for a reason, because at the end of the day, I was very sweaty and I was touching my brows as well. At the end of the day, it was still there. So that's my brow products that I'm going to mention right now. This is from Pink Honey, and this is their original Super Hold, the honey glue. I'm going to finish this one up, so I need to have the full size once this is done. This, it's better than SoBrow. It is the best product that I have to keep my rambunctious feeler brows in place. Plastered to my head, they are not going anywhere. They are like the bra corset for my brows. It keeps everything up and perky. If you have rambunctious brows that kind of have feelers and want to lie down because they're old and tired, this is this. Yes, honestly, they are a UK-based brand. There's that. But this is such a good product, their original super glue. And no, honey, it is vegan. The bee's knees, yes. Then the product that I use it with is from NYX. It's their Lift and Snatch Pen. And I have the shade Ash Brown. When I first got this, it made my brows a little bit red. But now that I have used it for quite a while, it is not red anymore. if I look in the camera, it's cool enough. I don't know, or in my mirror, I don't know how it translates on camera, but it is not as red as it used to be on camera. This does have a learning curve, yes. What I do though, is I have a cloth here, and before I use it, I do this. I touch it with the cloth, and when you are using it, sometimes you can kind of see that it forms excess product. And I do this again, and that way I can control it a little bit better, because yeah, there is kind of a learning curve. You should not be in a hurry when you're using this product, but honestly, once it is on and it has set, it's not going anywhere. I feel it is definitely worth it to learn to work with this product. Yes, then I want a sticky primer. If I'm going to use makeup at all, I want a sticky primer on my face. That's where this one comes in. I need a new one because this is almost out. This is from X Revolution. This is their Hydra Fix. This is the Milk Makeup Hydro Grip, but cheaper. And accessible if you are in Europe. Because the red one from e.l.f. we don't have here. So it's the watermelon one or something like that. We don't have here. So this, a gripping primer, which is affordable. It works very, very well. And honestly, I have compared it to the Milk Makeup Hydro Grip. They function exactly the same. This though, it's way cheaper and it often goes on sale. Yes, then I'm going to go to foundation. Because if I am going to wear a foundation, I want to wear a foundation that feels like nothing on the skin. That gives me coverage without making it look like I have foundation on. Which is weird because it's... never mind. The one that I pulled is this one from Fenty. This is not an olive though. I have shade 7, which is a neutral. So I need to green it up. But still, I have it on my face today. Once it has settled on my skin and everything is on, it's just so, so pretty. This gives me enough coverage on the days where I feel like I kind of need a little bit of coverage extra. I can build it up. Not indefinitely, but I can build it up. It still seems like my skin, but better. And that is what I want when it is very, very warm. So yes, I'm pretty makeuped right now. But when it is very, very hot, this is what I use. And then I just use a cream blush on top. And then basically I'm good to go with some freckles, obviously. Yeah, I really, really like this one. Okay, let's next go then to if I am going to be makeuped. Yeah, this needs to be in here because it's just, it is a summer favorite. And it's the KKW stick in light medium. This is what I use for cream bronzer, and this is also what I use for contour. Now, if I don't want to make a lot of effort, I just use it to cream bronze with, and not specifically cream contour. But yeah, this, it blends out like a dream. It's cool enough that I can use it as a contour, but it is still kind of warm enough that I can also use it as a bronzer. And I know technically a bronzer should be warmer. So if you're an olive, bronzers tend to quickly go red or orange or that, and this does not. It's the perfect base to put a powder bronzer on top if you want to. Truly, it's the yeah. Then for blush I kind of cheated because I pulled two. Yeah, I know, who am I. Let's start with this one, because when I am doing a very minimal makeup look, I kind of want to have a little bit of a hint of redder cheeks, you know. So if I'm doing my minimal makeup look, this is the blush that I use, and this is from MUA in the shade Watermelon. This gives me a very nice flushed look. It's also a very thin consistency. It's a skin tint, but then in a blush, and I think you can also use it. I tried it. I did not really like it, but you can also for the lips. You can, because it's basically kind of a multifunctional product if you want to. Now, the next product that I pulled, I have on my face right now. And this is when I am doing a different makeup look. I have a little bit more makeup on my face. And I also want to use a powder blush, because this is a blush that I can manipulate the shade of very, very well. And that's the Freck Cheek Slime. And I have the shade Fielding. This, for me, it's basically the shade of the cap. But I can manipulate it so, so effortlessly. I can make it a little bit more orange if I want to. I can make it a little bit more peach. I can just use it on its own. Yes. Yes. Obviously, we also need freckles. Why? because they're very, very summery. And if you're going to go for a minimal look, especially if you have hyperpigmentation and natural freckles, especially in summer anyway, I think a freckle pen is just the way to go. And then the only one that I use when I am more colored is the Freck. Because if I use one that is more red, like the Lottie London one that I use in winter, it looks like I have red spots. It looks like I have a rash in my face. I don't know why that is. It just is. And then I grab this one. The Freck is then perfect for me. Yes. Okay, it's expensive as hell, but it is worth it. I will get another one when it is on sale on Black Friday or something like that. So let's then next go to lips. For lips, I pulled two different products because, I don't know, I feel in summer it all needs to be a little bit glossy, you know? And I have fallen in love with lip oils. And this is a lip oil that I use a lot. This is from Catrice. It's one of their 5-in-1 lip oils in Cherry Blossom Glow. Now, I have two colors. I also have a red one. But this color, a lot of the time I wear this when I film on a Wednesday before I go grocery shopping and I'm going to wear a mask. And always when I have this one on, people are like, what do you have on your lips? Basically, it's my own lip color, but then with this on top. It's such a nice product. So, so nice. It does not feel gloopy. It has enough substance to stay on your lips a little while longer. So it's not you put it on and it's instantly gone like a dry oil. Because dry oils always feel a little bit drying for me, which is kind of weird because it's an oil. But this, it's just perfect. It's perfect. Now, what I also really love are glosses. There is one gloss that I have not stopped using ever since I ordered it and I got it in. And that one is from Lethal in the shade Nova. This gloss, it is, I want to say it's a dry gloss. Why? Because it feels like a lip oil, but it's a gloss. So here is the shade. It's on me, so I can put it on. It's so, so pretty. And it basically goes on top of a lipstick right now. And it works so, so well for that. Mm. And also the color. It's my perfect nude gloss, which is a little bit peachy. It's... honestly. Next is, if it is sweaty AF out, or if it is warm and I'm very, very sweaty and I want to do my no makeup makeup look, and I will put a picture up of the makeup look that I'm talking about. Basically, it is minimal makeup, it is a wing, it's a pop of color in the inner corner, and falsies. That is my go-to no makeup makeup summer look. But then I need a waterproof eyeliner. This is the one from NYX, and I either have the one from NYX or I have its equivalent in Catrice. This is the Epic Ink Liner, and the one from Catrice, I believe, is called the Tattoo Brush Ink Liner, but they are both waterproof. Yeah, unless it is extremely hot and I'm extremely sweaty, then this one just melts off because everything then melts off. It's then truly like the house of wax, but for the rest, this is the one. You need a waterproof eyeliner. Or a gel pot eyeliner, but I prefer a brush tip waterproof eyeliner. Yes, I am going to name a product now that is very, very new to my collection, but I feel it needs to be in here because I know I will use it a crap ton. It's truly new. I have used it for the second time today, so that is kind of saying something. It's from Kiss, and it is their Lash Glue Liner in Black. You can shake it up as well. Is it a felt tip? Yeah, it's a felt tip, but unlike other ones that I have tried, which are very dry and drag, this one, they drag your eyelid. This one is not as intense black as my Epic Ink Liner is, the one from NYX that I just showed you, but it is perfect. It just, and it is tacky already, so it is tacky enough to put your falsie on top of. It does not bleed, as you can see, it doesn't bleed. It stays on all day. And the best part is, I don't sweat this off. I feel like when I use a normal lash glue, that if my eyelid is a little bit teary-eyed or I sweat a little bit more, it almost breaks it up. Now, I know that I need to remove this with a waterproof waterproof makeup remover, but still I have to work for it. So I really have to let it soak. That is why this is, it's almost more of a favorite than my NYX Epic Incliner. Yes, I can make a wing with this. I don't really want to though, a big wing, because when I do a big wing, I have folds here. So I kind of make a whale tail thing. And I don't do that because I don't want stuff to stick together, because it does take a little while to dry down. But yeah, the best part is though, what I do when it is very hot, I paint a wing. I paint where I need my falsie to be. Then I grab my Epic Incliner and I paint the wing. And I paint over or above the liner to make the liner a little bit more intense. Not on top though, just above. And then I still have time to put my falsie on, because it just takes a little while to dry down. However, if you paint it on and you stick your falsie on immediately, that works too, because that's what I tried today. This, they, I think, also have in clear. I haven't seen it in clear because we have it in store in black. If you have trouble with falsies, this is the product that you need to try. Truly. Paint it on, stick your falsie on. Yes, I have one pair of falsies to mention. Yes, that's the pair of falsies that I have on right now. And why am I mentioning these? Because these are natural enough, but still impactful enough to work for me together in that look that I love so much, with it, which is that no makeup, whatever. And it is these from Primark, the 3D silk lashes, the baby doll lashes in style 723. Well, you cannot see them because I have them on, but let me get a pair so I can show you what they look like in the box. These are my favorite lashes right now, especially when it is hot. They are light enough, they are pretty enough, they are natural enough to be used on their own, but they are still impactful that I can use it with a darker look like I have today. They are just, I am glad that I have three boxes of these. Well, four if I count the ones that I'm wearing right now. So yeah, I know that the next time that I'm at Primark, which is going to be, I don't know when, but I need to stock up on these, I think, because these are just so, so good. I cannot link them because you cannot buy them online, but they are my favorites for summer. And then the last product that I'm going to mention is a mascara, because if I am not wearing any falsies, well, I'm wearing a mascara anyway. This is a mascara that has been my holy grail for years. Honestly, for ever since this one launched and I tried it, this is the one that I have been trying. And it is the Bye Bye Panda Eyes from Essence. This is a tube mascara. That means when it is hot as hell and my face is melting off, this stays on. Because you need to remove it with warm water. And you know, it stays on. Also, this does not eat up my falsies. So especially with this one from Kiss, I cannot do a mascara first and then a liner. I cannot. I need to do liner, then falsies, and then mascara. This one does not eat up my falsies. And also because I use it just to coat my lashes black when I have falsies on, it does not warp my falsie either. But it is, for me at least, also enough to wear on its own without falsies. If you want a tube mascara, you don't need to pay a lot of money. Get this one. That was it, guys, for today's video. Let me know some of your summer favorites. I will list all the products that I talked about today down below in the description box. If I can link stuff, I will link stuff. If I cannot, then I will not. Yes, that was it for today's video. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.